Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Paul from TechLink, and in today's video I want to show you how to back up your iPhone or iPad using iCloud. I'm also going to reveal a very important thing that no one tells you, something that you definitely need to know about iCloud backup. So make sure to watch through the whole video to find out what this is about before you even start using this service. Now, if you are using an iPhone or iPad, you should back up your device on a regular basis because it's a straightforward method and the best option to restore data if your device is replaced, lost or stolen, which, let's face it, happens to all of us and quite often. So if you are looking to back up your data on your iPhone or iPad, there's actually two ways to choose from. The first, and the one I'm going to describe in this video, is the iCloud backup, which is automatically encrypted and saved in the cloud. And you can create and access it from any location with a Wi-Fi connection. On the other hand, you can do a computer-based backup, which is created and kept on your Mac or PC. In this case, the encryption is optional and you must connect your device to your computer to restore it. But this is a topic for another video. Or if you are interested, you can check out my other video where I talk about how to back up your iPhone locally in an alternative way. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to make an iCloud backup of your iPhone or iPad without using a computer. Now, the first thing you want to do is connect your iOS device to a Wi-Fi network. This is important as it won't work over your mobile data. You then need to launch the settings app and tap the name of your profile or your profile picture. You will see there's an iCloud tab which you need to select, and in here you have to scroll down to iCloud backup. And you will see there's a switch which you can toggle on and off. Now, what this does, when it's in the green position, it will automatically back up your device every day as long as the screen is locked and it's linked to a power source and a Wi-Fi network. So the only thing you need to worry about is making sure you have enough available space on iCloud. Now, if you just started using Apple devices, know that you get 5 GB of iCloud storage for free. However, this is really not that much nowadays, but the good news is you can purchase 50 GB of storage for only 99p a month. But let's assume you want to back up your device manually. You can do so by simply tapping on this Backup Now button. This should take a few minutes or longer based on the speed of your Wi-Fi connection. And once it's completed, you will see underneath the date and time of your last backup. Now, a really important thing that most iCloud users tend to ignore is that Apple has a policy to delete unused iCloud backups 180 days after you disable these backups or stop using them. And I don't think there's anything wrong with this, it's just that Apple fails to warn people that their backups are about to be automatically deleted, like it happened to this guy here who lost years of drawings and other data because he ignored this Apple policy. So my advice, don't be like Erin, at least till Apple starts notifying their users that their iCloud backup is about to expire. If you decide to stop using their service, you should set a reminder to yourself that you need to move your data to another device or cloud service within 180 days. Or better yet, if you have enough storage on your computer, you should use the method I described in one of my previous videos, which I'm going to link in the description down below. And that's pretty much all you need to know on the iCloud backups. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Also, if you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up or share it with someone you think might benefit from it. And if you would like to see some similar tutorials, please subscribe to the channel. And like always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.